Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Hack. Today we're going to continue exploring the first level of the dungeon, and hopefully we'll get through it. And one thing you are going to notice in this video is that the in-game audio is going to be a bit quieter, and it's not going to be skipping as bad as it was. I figured out what was causing that, and I've fixed it, thankfully. Ah, a grappling hook. Those can actually be used to ascend and descend in pits, so if later in the game if I find a pit, I can choose to go down it instead of using a staircase to go down to the next floor, and I can likewise use it to climb up a pit if I find one in the ceiling. And I think after I clear this next room, I'm gonna rest. Because sitting at 2 hit points, and knowing my luck, something will end up sneaking up on me and killing me. So, okay, room is clear. Shut the door, and sleepy time. Alright, and this also means I can identify some items. So I am going to identify the the mirror and the bracers. See what we got here. Okay, some braces of protection, those are good. I think I will use those instead of the braces of archery, which I will just leave here. And a scrying glass. This can be used to identify items in place of using spells. So you just place an item in your hand and then use it. And then you pick up Potion of Water Breathing. Excellent. And the Bracers of Protection plus 2, what they do is they improve my armor class by 2. So, see, I'm sitting at 3 right now. Without them, I am sitting at 5. Definitely helpful to have, especially for a magic user, because eventually I am going to be switching out my armor for some robes if I find some magical ones later in. Okay, what do we got here? I think we'll go back and explore this portion first. Whoa. Oh, I saw a monster in there. Like a troglodyte. Nasty little black-skinned reptile people that when they hit you, it can weaken you. Which, for my character with his pretty low strength score, that can be very bad. So I will try to take that out with my bow, if possible. Ow. There would be an example of me running into my own ranged attacks. Oh, and there we go. I grow weaker. My strength is down to 13. Gonna hit it with a spell, I think. Burning hands. Haha. No, he had a whole bunch of stuff on him. both magical, good. Ah, Mage Scroll of Shield. I will probably be using this next level to give me an armor class bonus. Let's see, what else do we got here? Diamond Ring. Let's identify that. Ring of Protection plus 2, very good. Equip that, ups my armor class by 2 points. Well, a further 2 points, safe. From 6 it goes down to 4. And with my armor on, it goes down to 1. That's very good. We have a Wand of Hinder Foe, which I probably won't use too much, but nice to have, I guess. Okay, still gonna work towards this point here. Bumping into walls as I go. Ah, nothing. Okay, what else do we got? We're gonna go for this one next. It's a fairly straight shot. Get this one, this, and then this area up here. Ooh, magic sword. Okay, collect all my stuff here. And now with this sword, with weapons, you have to be careful because if you equip a cursed weapon, you won't be able to unequip it. And the only way to identify stuff is by equipping it to one of your hands. So if I'm not careful, I could end up with a cursed weapon for an undetermined amount of time. But we're gonna risk it. See what we get here. Okay, not cursed. Let's identify it. What we got? Ah, plus 2 longsword. I will keep that. Get rid of my old one. I'm going to hold on to that, and I think I'm going to start using that instead of my bow for the time being. And this onyx that we found is a key, actually, probably for that door we found earlier in. Oh, another scroll. Disintegrate, yes! That is another higher level spell on par with the death spell that I found earlier. But I'd say Disintegrate is probably a little better, because Death Spell really only works on weaker monsters, whereas Disintegrate is, it'll work on pretty much anything. And we found a little connecting door here, doesn't really do much for me, but I'm going to rest here, heal up a little bit. And another good thing about having this sword instead of my bow is I won't have to unequip my sword, or unequip my weapon to be able to use my spellbook, because a longsword is a one-handed weapon, whereas a bow is a two-handed weapon. So, that's good. I'll probably keep it in this same equipment setup until I pick up a magical short sword, or maybe some throwing knives or something, then I'll probably switch to just having my spellbook sitting over here. But until then, not a whole lot down here. and we have closed in on that 10-minute mark, so I'm going to call it an episode here. Bye, guys.